Hey friends, today we are doing Final Fantasy XI Chain of Promathia Mission 3. This is my first time doing it and I did not expect actually that this mission is gonna be super long. I made sure I save all the story. The cutscene. I made sure I get all the cutscenes. I also cut out all of the exploring because I think exploring in Final Fantasy XI takes so much time. There are some funny aspects in the story or comical which I would like to keep it as well. So the moment you enter port bus stop, there will be a cutscene with Prishay. And soon after that, you have to talk to Sid in the metalworks. Yeah, oh by the way, this is gonna be a long video because I combine all of the Chain of Promathia Mission 3 together. I know it's divided by 5 or 6 segments, but yeah, I decided that I'm compiled the whole things together. After finishing all the cutscenes, we have to go to Tenshodo. Just click in the big door and it should trigger another cutscenes. This is the Sandoria part of mission. I decided I did the Sandoria first because it's obviously shorter and easier and less hassle compared to the counterpart. Immediately after the cutscenes, you can go back. You can go back outside. Just before that, you turn right and go to the back room and talk with this NPC for another cutscene. Now you need to go to Carpenter's Landing, but from Jukner Forest. So you go teleport to Jukner Forest, the boss, and you go north right away. Using the north entrance. And have a small battle here with the NPC Elvan behind the boulder. Thank you. Once you done that, you can go back to South Sondoria and to the Mayor's Manor, the one in the corner of the map. It's gonna be a quite long cutscene. So that concludes the Sandoria part, and now we're going to the Windows version, which is quite a hassle. Funny, a hassle and annoying actually. So you go to Windows Wars and it will trigger the cutscene. and now you go to the rhinoceri. Immediately go to Yoran Oran at Winder's Walls and for another extreme cutscene. Head to the Winder's Waters and talk with the newspaper guy, NPC actually, the Hume Rome, to trigger another cutscene. Thank you. Now you have to go to the trader's home, which is on South Winder's Waters, and the one on the left of the map, to trigger another bizarre cutscene as well. And lastly, talk with Yoran Oran one more time before we leave to Tarongi Canyon. From Tarongi Canyon, you can go to Maze of Shakrami, and after Maze of Shakrami, then you can reach Atoa Chasm. Once you reach Atoa Chasm, there's this huge mountain called Paradamo Tor, and just slightly north of Paradamo Tor, there's this object on the ground you can click. It's loose sand, where you can, when you click and you spawn this notorious monster. Once you defeated it, click the loose sands again. And noticeable that it's really difficult to click for some reason, but once you got it, you have 30 minutes to climb Paradamo Tor. 30 minutes. If you pass 30 minutes, and the key item will disintegrate, and you have to click the loose sands again, and climb this Paradamo Tor once again. Fortunately, I did climb this mountain once to complete just one simple ridiculous quest. I did it, but that was in 2017, I guess, and I barely having hard time remembering it. So yeah, you can see me. I fast forward my progress because it's gonna take too long if I didn't. But yeah. I did my best trying to remember. The worst part is that I don't even remember my school studies, but I still remember this Final Fantasy path. Ridiculous, but okay. I remember there are some gases that permanently block your way, but there are some that actually after a minute it will disappear. Unfortunately, I don't remember which is which. I just 100% feeling 100% Rambo, I think. Yep. It was told if you do any teleportation or any teleport while doing this mission, it will automatically fail the mission. I mean, it will destroy the key item. Well, I'm not gonna try though. This is actually my second time climbing, yes. So immediately back to Yoran. We'll go to Port Winders and talk with this Yujuju. You may need to click two times. I need to click two times for some reason. I think it's a quest related thing. Now go to Winder's Waters of Tistery and talk with this NPC to trigger another cutscene. now go to Yoran Oran for the last time. It's nearly concluding this segment. For the final part of this mission segment, you need to go to Metalworks and talk to Sid. And that should conclude the segment. When you go to lower Juno, it will automatically trigger the cutscene. And when you're done, you can go to Tenshodo and to trigger another cutscene. Now you go to Upper Juno near the auction house and you talk with this NPC. Now we have to go to Soja, but I did make a mistake. To open this door in Soja, you need to have a Soja pass. And to get a Soja pass is you go to Soja to kill any spider NPC, spider monster, and it will drop some stones. Any stone, you only need one. Once you get the stone, you go back to Tenshodo and trade it with the NPC just in front, behind the main gate, and you will get the Soja pass. Once you got the Soja pass, then you can go to this dungeon from the glacier's post right next to it, then you can go here. The mission name should be Darkness Name. Ironically, this is my first time seeing or fighting Diabolos. I never had a chance to fight him during my prime time back then, because I had to quit the game before I got myself an access to this Promathia missions. immediately go back to Upper Juno near the auction house again and to conclude the mission. With this concludes the whole Transient Dream meta mission. I would call it meta mission, yeah. But back then, meta doesn't invent. The word meta game is not invented yet, I guess. Yeah. I honestly did not expect this whole meta mission is gonna be like 58 minutes long. I even cut out all my running, all my attempt and such. All I just did is to save the cutscenes. And it's bloody 58 minutes, which is proof of this Final Fantasy XI is very story rich. So for people that actually enjoy the story, this game offers you a great deal of story. I do recommend this game though. Yes, I do recommend this game even in 2022. So thank you for watching, guys. I do hope this video is entertaining you, and yeah, I'll do another mission next Chain of Promathia, and I will record it again, see how's the story, because I haven't done it before. So yeah, it's kind of enjoying for myself as well. Cheers, guys.